with. But I adjusted, I didn't really adjust the ration, but I planned out how much feed we'll be using for the bigger mixer, because I'm kind of getting to the point where we're taking out a lot of loads with this little one. So I think we might as well just use that big red mixer we have. Probably go quite a bit quicker. I'll just get these cow bales put in and we'll be about ready to go. I think I could have done another three there. Dude. Now, let's just see where that gets us.
You want it dumped in there, or are you going to make a ration?
back it up into the bay there, and you can start unloading and pull forward as it unloads. You probably have to be pretty quick on that, so get moving forward before you start unloading. I kind of had a little mess with my hay here before I got that cleaned up.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So that's what happens. Nice if we did have a hay buster or something, but this is what I'm making do with. But it's the hay and the straw that just piles up so fast. Silage and the wet distillers, on the other hand, is a different game. And I keep backing up. I wanted to move forward there.
That's what we use, is we use our mixers for grinding hay too, so.
Oh, okay. I guess I didn't really know if anybody did that or not.
We have a hay buster too, but we use it basically just for high moisture corn.
Right, okay. See, the feedlot I worked for, they used it for both grinding hay and the high moisture corn. Alright, let's do that again.
I got some left in here. You want to fill it back up or what?
Nope, let's just empty it out and call it good. I don't need to fill up this bay right away if we don't go through straw too fast. It's hay that I have to refill every single day. Beats. Alright, I'd say you can probably go ahead and park that by the other roto mix in the shed behind the commodity shed here. Do that and probably go ahead and attach that Massey, or if you'd rather run the Fent, doesn't matter, but we need one of those on that red vertical mixer in the back. But I don't care which tractor you run, they'll both haul it just fine, I think. think this is the first time I'll be using this thing to actually feed. I just used this the first time to grind our hay. Probably end up getting rid of those roto mixes at some point.
Okay, so this thing's a four screw.
Yup, she's a big one. But it's just these feeding live streams I'm doing, I just think they're a bit too long, and I have to take so many trips with the roto mix.
Right.
I think this will be just fine. I'm gonna go refill this thing with some fuel, and then we can get feeding. Okay, where's my ration chart at? Where did I put that? That's this key there, okay. Yeah, I guess with this now, we just have to feed once a day. That'll be alright. Oh shoot. Ah, crap. My steering wheel is not working. Okay. Guess I'll be using the keyboard then.
Your wheel quit?
Apparently I didn't plug it in.
So what do the distillers account for in game?
They're the equivalent of silage. That's... oh, shit. We might have to come back to this in a sec. I might have to save and re-upload the pecan, however you pronounce it, this feeder. I don't think it's ready to handle distillers right now. Okay. Well, I'm gonna shut this off and save the game and we'll come back. I just remembered I only added that to Rotomix. Shoot. No, this won't take too long to fix that. I'm doing terrific, aren't I? Oh, at least this gives me a chance to plug in my wheel here.
Yeah, no kidding.
There we go. And time for the loud startup process. Where is that line at? That's not good. Okay, there we go. I just have to add the wet distillers line under silage. And we'll be good. All right. That's all I needed to do. And for those watching the stream, sorry about this little inconvenience here. I will be back up and running any minute now. Okay. That is uploading right now. And I just have to re-upload it to the server and we'll be ready to go. Alright, I'll get this link sent over to you, Adam.
Okay.
There it is. And now I just have to get it on the server. Well, I'm glad I remembered that before I actually went to load the distillers and not realize what was going on.
No kidding.
Alright, server's back up and ready to go.
Freaking mess outside, it's snowing, raining, icing.
Oh geez, that's, yeah, a mess is probably an accurate term for that. We're getting the melt from the snow here that we got this last weekend, and it's making a mess where I work, and roads are just muddy as hell. It was fine for a while there. It actually finally dried up, but then we got hit with more snow, and then a mess ensued.
A lot of gravel roads out there.
Yeah, quite a bit. Just the roads where I work, just some back alley stuff. There were not much gravel to begin with, so that made it even worse in the end. Plus, you know, there's already potholes and crap in that and dips, and then that means I end up spilling a little bit of manure going over that because I'm running a bit too fast. That gets all in there. But what the heck? I thought I had saved. Shit. Okay, I guess we'll regrind that straw then.
Gonna be one of them days.
Apparently. I guess I had simply just logged in as a admin. I must not have saved. I just put in there. I guess we'll go ahead and do the full load this time. Alright. Oh, luckily this doesn't take too long. And of course I'm lagging in some machinery collisions here. There we go. While you're doing that, I can get this thing refilled again. And yeah, Jason, that bail fork that I'm using does have auto load on it. It works with squares and rounds, and it's adjustable as well. You can raise and lower the pylons on it. It's part of a pack called the CSZ equipment here. Find that on a lot of websites. I think Google is easy enough, and FSUK probably has it, as well as I think even Giant's Mod Hub even has the CSZ set on there. You got a lot of stuff in here. Useful for a lot of stuff. Although, for whatever reason, their buckets don't hold a lot of these commodities, which I was kind of upset about that, but that's not a big deal.
Yeah, I'm sure you can get that anywhere.
Yeah, I have no doubt it's on all the major mod sites out there. Probably even most of the sketchy mod sites too. I think I've used the CSZ set since 15. I don't remember if they had it in 13 or not, but if they did, I'm pretty sure I probably used it then too. Alright, there we go.
That fork works pretty good for pushing that up.
Oh, it does. First time, one of the first times I was pushing up hay, I was using the Degelman blade on one of our Steigers. And it just did not work well. Then I tuned it up with this fork here, and it did a beautiful job. Actually, get it up high. Unlike the Degelman blade, that thing only goes so high. And it picks up a lot too. Like, this thing has a 10,000 liter capacity on it. I was thinking of making a new bucket for feeding, but we might as well just use this.
Do like a 7-yard bucket.
What's that?
Do like a 7-yard bucket.
Oh yeah. And yeah, you can go trade that off with the other mixer.
I got freaking 1,500 pounds left in here.
Oh, do you?
If I'd have known that was it, I wouldn't have stopped.
Oh yeah, alright, go ahead and just put that down. Hell, you can do it right there if you wanted to, I can grab it. Yeah, when I was just doing hay before you got on, I was in a really bad spot and I didn't get out of the bay soon enough, so I had the hay pushed that rotomix and jackknifed it in there. So I had to reset it.
Oh god.
Yeah, it was not fun.
I could see how that would happen though.
Oh yeah, it's not too difficult to get in a bad spot with that. It just unloads so fast too. I think the P-cone on, pronounce it, I just need to figure that out. The big mixer, we'll just call it that. We'll call it the big mixer. That, I think that unloads a bit slower, but I could be wrong. I guess I could pull back up the ration window there.
How do you bring that up?
I have that set up on a hotkey on my Open Broadcaster software. It lets you pull up different windows and you can move them around to different spots on the screen. So I just took a screenshot of my Excel spreadsheet and add it, lead to that file path, and bound it to a key, and so whenever I hit the key, it pops up. I have gotten some questions about that before, about whether it's a mod or not. No, not a mod, it's just part of Open Broadcaster software and something that I made myself. And I think I did tell you, I do have a Google spreadsheet of our rations.
Yeah, you'll have to hook me up with that one day.
Yeah, just in case I'm not around. Let's try this one more time. Yeah, it's pretty easy to remember this stuff too, especially when you do it a million times. I pretty much have this memorized. And here is where we make the hay disappear.
Would it be possible to script like grass as its own haylage?
I guess I really don't know. I guess I don't see why not, but I would have literally no idea how one would go about doing that.
Right.
Where do I gotta get to now? I guess I did forget what I need here. 38% is what I'm gonna do. And almost had that perfect. There, Rick, Ty, and Blackout Gaming. Glad you guys could join in for the stream today, as well as anybody else that has joined in. I haven't really been on top of the chat here. I wish those fill planes would work better in multiplayer, or actually worked at all in multiplayer.
No kidding.
Just big block in the middle bucks the hell out of me. Oh, this silage gets heavy, holy crap. Squatting these front tires. I think I need like another bucket and a half of that. Use more silage than any other commodities, but it's the one pile that goes down the slowest. Oh crap. It's got a bad spot here.
Easy.
gotta keep wiggling it out. I guess this thing is gonna be scratched to hell. Probably gonna have some chunks of this concrete and plywood out. Wow, that was not pretty at all.
Boy, that thing really does got her pants full.
Oh yeah. And oh, this thing, it shakes like crazy whenever I make the slightest turn. Why am I not using my wheel? I got that plugged in. Then it wouldn't shake so much, probably. Yeah, we use a lot of silage. But yeah, it would be nice if we did have the halage separate.
I'd save. You wouldn't have to feed so much dry hay then.
Yeah, for sure. Because that just goes down so damn fast.
We're like a 70-40 or 70-30 probably for silage to halage. Or silage to hay, basically.
Okay. Yeah, what's... I mean, I should say here. Yeah, I got... 8% straw, 30 hay, 54 silage, and 8% wet distillers. I would decrease the hay more, but then there's the set defaults that Giants has set. Well, I guess I could change that in the mixer XML. I guess it would be fine. I could do even less hay than what I have now. I suppose I can change that sometime. But I would kind of like to use more silage. Then we can actually put up more silage and actually utilize these big ass piles.
Right.
And of course, this fork does not handle WD. Alright, I guess I'll trade off quick. That's just unfortunate. Luckily, most of these like newer payloaders have the quick release attachers. This bucket's just about the right size for straw and our wet distillers. Alright, there's load number one. So I figured we could just do this. Take the rig into each.
I'll just ride with you. You got a passenger script in there?
I guess I don't know for sure.
Negative.
Well, then I'll let you go ahead and do that. That's usually how I do it. If I have another guy, I usually just do the loading and they'll go and unload. So, basically just do it one part of the stall at a time. I kind of just start at this end here where I'm standing and work my way to the other side. So there's four.
You take this whole load in this pen?
Yep. So each of these, not each of the fill planes, but each fill plane on one side is separate from the one on the other side. So I kind of like doing them all separately. So we'll take four loads into the freestalls, and then the last load, the fifth load, will be taken to split between the two heifer sheds.
Is that a different ration, or are you just feeding them the same thing?
I'm just feeding them the same thing. I don't see any need to go into that much detail.
Right.
Blackout Gaming, we have exactly 537 head right now, and I'm hoping to work my way up to 1200 at some point. Oh shit. Oh wait, that's because we met this morning too. I think for now, I'm gonna start with just two loads. Because I just remembered our ration is currently set up for a lot more head than we currently have. So, we're probably overfeeding them just a little bit right now. We'll just do one more load and call it good for today. Dominator, I do not offer any CD keys, and you will be putting them out temporarily because that's not really something you need to be asking in a live stream. Not a place for such things.
What did he ask?
You could get a CD key for FS17.
Oh god.
Yeah. I wish this scale on this thing actually worked. Cool. The readout is so small on it though.
Where is the scale head on this thing?
It's right on the front there. For you to see from the back window.
Yeah, it is teeny.
I think the ones on the RotoMix are a lot bigger.
How do I turn on player speed again?
You hit button 1, 2, or 3, and that adjusts your speed accordingly. So 3 is the fastest, 1 is the slowest. As for how many acres the map is, I'm not too sure, Jake. I have not actually gone in and figured that yet. But that's in my list of things to do. And Nick asks, I'm sure you've answered many times, but what is WDG? It's, so that stands for Wet Distiller's Grain. It's basically, well, it is a byproduct from corn for producing ethanol, and it is used in feed.
Should put a mixing pit in somewhere around here.
A mixing pit? I can't say I've ever seen one of those.
Oh, I don't know if I have a picture anymore. Basically what it is, a hole in the ground, you put the mixer in it so the payloader guy only has to lift halfway, you know?
Oh, yeah, okay. I know what you're talking about now.
Makes it lots easier for shaking your bucket.
Yep.
Instead of being lifted all the way up, you know?
Yeah, I could probably, well, maybe I could find a place to do that. I might just, if I wanted to do that, I'd probably cut out some of these trees and fence and maybe do it right by the shed here. I guess I did put in this road because Pat was bitching about having to go across the scale every time he was hauling in silage. So maybe if I took the road out or something, or... oh, I could figure that out. That'd be nice to have. Hell, even if I just had a ramp up for the payloader or something.
Yeah, you could do that too.
And again, here I was just using my keyboard to steer. Why do I do that?
I mean, ours is a little different, of course. I put it in our group chat, but
because
we do all the loading, all the loading's done inside.
Oh, okay, I see. Maybe at some point, if I did a major overhaul of the map, I could redo our dairy, and that looks pretty nice. Oh.
Yeah, we, in the beginning of the day, after we faced the piles, we haul all the haylage and silage inside that building so the payloader never has to leave.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Everything's just loaded right there. Kind of what you got here. I mean, it's the same thing. You're not going anywhere else, but just loading right here.
Yeah. Well, this was very similar to the area that I briefly worked at. They had their commodity shed. I mean, it was all outside right next to their silage pile so they could fill up the bay easily. And let's see. Yeah, no, I mean, this is just what I was used to seeing.
Right. I mean, this is what our old one was like. Pretty much identical.
Right, I gotcha. One thing I would have liked to have done different is somehow made it closer to the free stalls and where we're actually feeding. Because right now we're kind of driving a little ways to get where the feeding is actually happening. I'm all about that efficiency.
That's how you make the money.
Oh yeah. I think Jake is saying, I like the scales, it's nice to keep track of how much crop you have. We really didn't utilize that for our silage. I really didn't see much need to weigh all our silage, but I mostly just wanted to do that for the wet distillers coming in. There's load 2. I guess you can take that wherever you want. It will be nicer when I do get my full amount ahead, then I can actually like spread out the feeding a little bit better. It was nice. It was perfect for when we were using the roto mix, because it was 6 loads we were hauling, and there's exactly like 6 spots to unload. 4 places in the freestall and then the 2 heifer sheds. It was ideal. to move that bucket in case we load some more of this.
Who was the unlucky one to pile all these bales?
Oh, that was me. I figured since I'm kind of running the dairy stuff here, I would take care of the bitch work. But it wasn't that bad. Trailers we were using, they have auto load on them, so me and Jake went out and loaded those and hauled them back. And then I was just sitting here. If he was running the truck, I was sitting waiting here with the bale spear, stacking what he had unloaded, because they have auto unload as well.
Yeah.
And the bale spears have an auto load function. And believe me, this is the worst that this pile has looked. It was so much neater at the beginning. But
well,
once
they move around so much.
Yeah, once you start getting into another pile and you start pushing them back just to keep it tight, it just moves everything around and pushes everything. Lagoons are getting a bit higher. I guess I don't know exactly how much I set them to hold. But once we get soybeans done, then we'll be hauling all the shit we got.
Do you want to keep using the new ones, or you want to put the hools in here?
Do we have some hools to use?
Yeah, I got some. I think there are no errors on them, too.
Well, yeah, I'll definitely use those. I think that's what Jake wants to use, and Dusty, too, and I kind of prefer them. I'm sure they have high capacity as well.
Yep, I don't like dunes.
Yeah.
Did you ever see their new fiberglass tank?
No, I haven't.
Oh, God, it's ugly.
Yeah, I mean, if you just want to send that over, I'll get the Lincoln Creek logo and a couple of number sets put on them. That's what we do here. At some point I do want to get a different solid spreader. Not that I don't like this big thing because it hauls a lot, but I kind of prefer something a little more American.
Right. Do you guys run all box spreaders out there?
For the most part, yeah. I don't know, the dairy that I worked at, they had a custom crew come in with the box trucks that were hauling out.
Yep.
They had the boxes on them, and the lot I was working for, they were running some Myers boxes as well. I guess I haven't really seen much for side slinging or any other type that there might be.
That's how we run our V spreaders.
Yeah, and I guess as for even liquid manure, I don't see too many tankers. A lot of it's drag hose.
We do both, depending, like corn grown, everything we do is transferred. We transfer it with semis into a frat tank,
yeah,
and then pump it out to the drag line. But like hay grown, we'll throw splash pans on the back of the semis and run the semis in the fields.
Oh, I gotcha. I haven't actually seen any of that before. And you could probably just leave that tractor attached to the mixer. We'll probably just keep it on there. And this vent has not seen any action yet.
Is this the one Dusty did?
Yep. At one point, I do want to get passenger script on it. Dusty was the one that added passenger stuff to our mods, and I kind of like to get light cones on all of our machines too. If you got them on one, you gotta have them on all.
Right. Should see if we can get the hubs on here for the dual.
Oh yeah. You want to take this skid-steer out if you're going to stick around and help for a little bit. And push up. Holy shit, we got a lot of feed up by the heifer sheds. That's where I kind of have those triggers set. It's over here. I do have a different tire scraper model. I don't like using this one. So I need to get that retextured and re-in-game soon. I can go see if there's anything else I need to do, or just pushing up feed is all that's left. I probably hauled a little bit too much wet cake here, because this pile's going by slow. I think I had two loads hauled in. I think we only needed one. I guess I could at the very least get this truck ready to haul some manure. And yes, sir, man, we were running a different mixer wagon this time. I decided to go with the bigger one this time around. Probably just be parking or selling those roto mixes for now.
Do you have to push feedback into freestall barns or not?
Nope. Just that's kind of one of the limitations with cows in 17 now. You can only have one of these, quote, messy triggers set up total. So I figured it'd just be better to just have the one outside here. Yeah, what are they doing here? Oh, that's why that's not working. Duh. Oh, that is set up for space. Okay, that's why that wasn't working. Duh, I knew that. Wait, no, I didn't. Probably get a different trailer to haul manure with than the one that I'm hauling wet distillers. Glad you could join in today, Jake, and hopefully we'll see you in the next stream. Have a good day. was not very good on my part. Oh yeah, it tends to do that a little bit. I'll come with the loader bucket and clean that up.
I was just about to ask, can you only push a certain amount of this back or what?
Nope. Sometimes it just loses the trigger somehow. I don't know how that all works, but sometimes it does that to me. It's just a pain in the neck. Right now, Shiva Man, the cows have plenty of water to last them a couple of days, I think. Yeah, their water can last them another day or two. Once that feed gets like so far away, it's like really hard to get that all cleaned up and pushed back over. And this is a 4X map there. Guess I have no idea how I pronounce that username. And I'm not gonna even try to. Alright, well, I think that's pretty much everything we have to do today. At least until you guys are harvesting tonight, but I don't think I'll be around for that.
I'm not sure if I'll be around either. I don't know. I think the old lady wants to go out tonight.
Oh, fun. Alright, well, for everybody in stream, thanks for watching, and have a great day. We'll catch you next time.